On Google Calendar, do you ever wish you could just share part of your calendar so that somebody would be able to create appointments but not see all of the appointments in your main calendar? Maybe it's somebody in another team or from another business, and you'd be happy for them just to be able to book appointments on your behalf in your calendar. What you can do is create a new calendar without creating a new email address for yourself. So I'm going to show you in Google Calendar how to create a new calendar, how to share it, and what the people at the other end, if they're using Google Calendar, what they need to do to be able to access that calendar. So I'm in Google Calendar on the desktop, and this is my main calendar here. And what I want to do is create a new calendar, but still belonging to my main email address. So what we do is we click on the plus sign here to create a new calendar. And so let's say that this calendar is about YouTube and YouTube video creation. And then I've got my time zone, I'm keeping that as is, and I'm going to create that calendar. So that calendar is going to appear in, it's successfully created. That calendar is going to appear in my own calendar for my main email address. So the first thing I want to do is change the color. So to do that, I go to my calendars here and then I just hover over here, the three dots, and I can change it to red because red is pretty much the color of YouTube, right? And so appointments that I create in that YouTube video creation calendar are going to be red. Well, that's a blue one because that belongs to the wrong calendar. So let me change that calendar, make a video, and I want to change that calendar to be my YouTube video creation calendar. You see, it automatically switches it to red. But now the next thing is I want to share that calendar. And to do that, I click on the three dots again, settings and sharing. Now I've got a few options here, but what I want to do, these people are not part of my current domain. So what I want to do, and there's, you can get into more details into sharing your calendar, but I can either send them a link or add people if I know their email address. You simply click on the add people and you can enter their email address. Now it's very important. Do you want them simply to see the event details, or you just want them to see that you are free or busy at that time? Or do you want to allow them to make changes to events? Or even to share your calendar on with somebody else? So that might be if it's a group kind of calendar. I'm going to select Make Changes to Events and then click Send. And at the other end, the person who has received the invitation to edit or view your calendar needs to add it to their list of calendars. And to do that, they simply need to add this calendar. Click on that. To do that, they simply need to click on Add This Calendar. And then in Google Calendar, they get this option to click Add. And so there it is there. And we can see that that event has come in there. They may want to change the calendar color at their end. And once again, they can change that just by clicking on those three dots, change it to red. By the way, if you just want to change the color of an individual event, you can click on here and click Edit Event, and then change that color to something different altogether and save. Now that you've shared your new calendar, it's like a sub-calendar with some other party. Now they can go and add events and update them and even delete them, depending on what permissions you have given them. And that's all in Google Calendar.